Good evening, my dear students. So in the last videos, we discussed about the boilers and turbines. Now today, we are going to discuss about the last part of module number 2, and that is hydraulic pumps. So you all are familiar about the pump, because in our daily routine life, we come across the pump, different types of pumps. Okay, so first we define, see, pump is a device that transfer the energy to lift or to raise the liquid from lower level to the higher level. It is nothing but the pump. So it can circulate the liquid in a closed system. See, in our house we use the pump to lift the water from the lower level to the higher level, that is overhead tank. See, pump is used in pumping the water for agriculture, irrigation work, in steam power plant for condensing water, then in the boiler to enter or to feed the water into the boiler drum, then in case of the machine tools to circulate the coolant or liquid, etc. Now we are going to classify the pumps. So broadly, the pump is classified as first centrifugal pump, reciprocating pump and rotary pump. So what is centrifugal pump? See, basically one rotating member is considered, that is impeller. What is impeller? It is a rotating member. So when impeller rotates, it creates the centrifugal force, and therefore the liquid is raised from one portion to the other portion. So what is reciprocating pump? So you all are familiar about the piston and the cylinder. In case of the IC engines, piston reciprocates inside the cylinder to develop the power. Similarly, here in case of the reciprocating pump, what happens? The piston reciprocates inside the cylinder, and therefore it gives the energy to the liquid, so that the liquid can be lifted from lower end to the higher end. And third one, rotary pump. See, rotary pump means it consists of rotating members. This pump consists of rotating members, for example gears, vanes, screws, etc. And because of the rotating member, what will happen? The pressure is raised, and the liquid or fluid can be lifted from one portion to the other portion. Now next we are going to discuss the pump specification. First one, maximum discharge pressure. See, I told you the pump is designed for the particular pressure. So according to that pressure only that pump will operate. If the pump is designed for the pressure 2 bar or 3 bar, that pump will not operate for the pressure of 5 bar or 10 bar. One example I am giving you. Okay. So second one, maximum discharge flow. The pump is designed for the maximum flow. Then discharge size. Size of the outlet connection. We do the connection at the outlet, so that size of the outlet, it is nothing but discharge size. Next, horsepower. It is used to express the rate at which the mechanical energy is released. So we know that how we consider the pump capacity: 1 HP, 2 HP, 3 HP and so on. Then types of the pumps: centrifugal pump, gear pump, vane pump, etc. Then power. The pump may be designed for AC power, DC power, air, pneumatic, hydraulic, etc. And lastly, housing material. The material for the pump housing may be aluminium, cast iron, stainless steel, etc. Thank you.